just have a tremendous amount of new shows to announce. 11 new series we announced today. New shows from Rocco Dispirito, Brad Goreski, Jeff Lewis, and Jenny Pulos, Chris March from Project Runway, on and on and on. And it's an incredible slate that we've worked so hard on. And, you know, I feel so good about just building on our success and, you know, developing right into our core audience, which is the most educated and the most affluent on all of cable. We're celebrating my 100th episode of Watch What Happens Live next Thursday. I'm so excited about that, and there's a lot of big live surprises coming up this summer.
So the show basically tracks myself, my struggle with infertility, and also 16 of my more outlandish clients and their requests in the last weeks of their pregnancy. And what I do is I come in with my team of experts and we do whatever it is that they're doing. It can range from the biggest, best baby shower, or it can be somebody that's completely not ready to be a parent and needs to be whipped into shape. And each episode, we sort of uncover new things about the moms and the parents that they really emotional side. So the show has both like laughter and fashion, but also a lot of tears. And at the end of the day, everybody has a baby. I mean, I think when people see the show, it is outlandish and crazy, but at the end of the day, all these people want to be great parents. And for me, it's showing America what I get to do. What I get to do is really help people prepare for this most amazing moment in their life.
What I'm really excited about is people are going to get to fall in love with the idea of having dinner parties again. It's a bit of a lost art in America, but the dinner party, the table, is where we have our most fun, where we let our hair down, let our guard down, so where we connect with human beings on a deep level. And I grew up with it, and all my favorite moments happen around the dinner table. So I'm so excited that Bravo believes that that's an important story to tell. The way the show works is there are three chefs who start. One chef gets eliminated right away. Two chefs throw competing, consecutive dinner parties. They're responsible for everything, the decor, the service, the beverages, and all the food. And then six celebrity guests help me decide who threw the best dinner party. There is no other show on television like this show. It literally combines pop culture, fashion, design, celebrity, and culinary all in 1 hour. There's nothing like it on TV right now.
Great about, you know, Tabitha Salon Takeover and hairdressing salons are really just, it's always surprising even for me. I go in there not expecting half the things to happen that happen, and I'm always totally gobsmacked when they do. So, you know, you'll find more drama, I'm sure you'll find more craziness, I'm sure there'll be things being thrown across salons again, and the rest will have to wait and see. We're still going to be doing Tabitha Salon Takeover, which will be in season 4. What we're doing with the other shows are actually taking over other businesses. So I'm going to be using my business expertise to go in and take over non-hairdressing salons and tackle all the problems that we tackle with Tabitha Salon Takeover and the hairdressing salons, but obviously in different businesses.
You're definitely going to step it up. You're going to see harder challenges, a higher caliber of chefs competing. You know, there's always going to be drama. At any pastry kitchen, whether it's a camera or no camera involved, there's always drama and there's always passion.
What I learned last year was pastry chefs, my dear friend and our head judge included, are crazy. So there's going to be even more insanity. I think it's only going to get more intense. So I hope we'll have less tears, but I can't promise. I know we'll have challenges that you cannot believe. I know the visuals will be outstanding. I know it's gonna be bigger and bolder and even more delicious, if that's possible.
You're definitely gonna see a lot of challenges that you didn't see in the first season, showing a lot of different technique that you didn't see in the first season, forcing the chefs out of their comfort zone.
I'm getting hungry just talking about this.
Oh, yeah.
I think my tummy is rumbling if you hear that. I think the chefs are going to know. I mean, they've seen one season. They saw our stellar chef testings in season 1. They're going to know. They've got to bring it. And I can't even imagine. I think you'll find some chefs with great renown joining us.